What's up, guys? This is Pavel from the Prosocial Collective, and we're here today in Kensington Square, the oldest square in London, founded in 1685. And that concludes the history lesson for today, because today I want to talk to you about procrastination, specifically why we procrastinate. Now, procrastination is one of the best examples of that collision, that constant struggle between two parts of the brain, the prefrontal cortex and the limbic system. Now, the prefrontal cortex is only the most recent upgrade to our operating system, if that makes sense. It's responsible for problem solving, higher thinking, abstract thinking, rationalizing. Now, my only regret at this point is that I don't have a scientific voice. Anyway, millennia ago, we didn't even need that part of the brain. All we needed to do was sustain ourselves through nourishing ourselves, running away from dangerous situations, and being able to pass on our genes. All humans really needed at that point in time was the primitive brain, the brainstem, and the limbic system. The brainstem is vital for processes like breathing, heart rate, movement. The limbic system, on the other hand, is the set of structures surrounding the brainstem, forming a border around it. Now, the limbic system is responsible for motivations, emotions, and long-term memory. It's the part of the brain that makes you think, ooh, I'd eat that. I'd drink the drink out of that drink. Hey, yo, why are you touching my girl? Sex! So the limbic system is responsible for purely survival behavior. It's automatic, it's instinctive, and it has absolutely nothing to do with conscious thought. If it helps you remember, you can remember the four Fs: feeding, fighting, fleeing, and mating. Now, the reason I don't break into your home and interrupt that very romantic candlelit dinner and snatch that beef bourguignon right off the table and steal your girlfriend is because the prefrontal cortex I have rationalizes these impulses. Sorry. It actually says, come off it, stupid. The sad thing is that the prefrontal cortex is weaker than the primitive brain. That's because the primitive brain was evolved first and the prefrontal cortex just recently. This is why we can't rationalize our emotions. Evolution of our brain went upwards from the brainstem through to the limbic system and up to the prefrontal cortex, which is very recent. So whenever it comes to procrastination, the limbic system is the main culprit and can easily beat the prefrontal cortex. So since the limbic system will always win, does that mean I have an excuse to procrastinate forever? No. Cheeky.
The prefrontal cortex tries to keep our impulsive part of the brain in check, but as the day goes by, you make more and more decisions, and your prefrontal cortex just gets worn out. It gets more and more worn out by the amount of decisions you make. And from the moment you wake up, every single day, you make a ton of decisions. Snooze or no snooze, porridge or Rice Krispies, crocodile skin loafers or suede moccasins, Bic pen or fountain pen with an electroplated engraved nib. And as the day goes by, these constant decisions just tire us and we're more susceptible to procrastination because we just simply lose our willpower.
But once deadline day is fast approaching and you have to revise for your exam or write your assignment for tomorrow, does the urgency kick in and your prefrontal cortex and your limbic system start to cooperate? So what do you guys think of procrastination? Leave some comments below or procrastinate no longer and subscribe to my channel.